Hello everyone, welcome to Evoalytics. This is Shigan here, and in the previous class we have been discussing about power systems part 14, about fuses and their characteristics and different types of materials used for making fuse depending upon their current characteristics. So we have seen about liquid fuses and their characteristics and the important formulae used for fuses. Today we are going to deal with power systems part 15 and types of relays. So this is also a very important topic, and here I am going to provide you some classification of relays depending upon their construction and time of operation and application, depending upon application. Okay, so depending upon construction, relays are classified as electromagnetic relays. So these are used for both AC and DC. AC and DC, and the torque produced is directly proportional to square of the current. Electromagnetic relays. So we can see attracted armature type relays and balanced beam type relays. So these are two types of relays which comes under electromagnetic relays. So next comes induction type relays. So these are used for AC only, and torque is proportional to I, and we have induction disk type and induction cup type and shaded pole type. And watt hour. These are different types of relays classified on construction. So next comes, depending upon time of operation, we have instantaneous relays. These generally have operating time of less than 0.1 second. So this comes under either balanced beam or induction cup. So next comes inverse time relays. Inverse time relays are nothing but current and time are inversely proportional. So next comes DMT, definite minimum time interval. So for these, for any magnitude of fault current, operation time is constant. What might be the current, the time will be constant. So next comes IDMT relays, inverse definite minimum time relays. So these are combination of DMT, I mean definite minimum time relays, and inverse time relays. So these are the combination of time of both inverse time relays and definite minimum time relays. Next we are going for application point of view. So here we have overcurrent relays, over current relays. So in over current relays, it depends upon the magnitude of current, and these are half directional and non-directional. Okay, so we also have differential relays. So and distance relays. Distance relays are nothing but this depends upon V by I ratio, generally known as impedance ratio. So impedance relays, impedance relays, more relays, and reactance relays. So this is complete classification of types of relays, but we can't expect questions from construction or their working or any type of physical classification of relays. So in general, questions might be asked from application point of view. So just to have a brief idea about types of relays, I had mentioned these key points, and please just make a screenshot, and it's not necessary to by heart it or to deliver. So the chart now I'm going to provide is much more important than any other. So applications of relays. Applications of relays. Okay. So for long transmission lines and at fault, we employ directional overcurrent relay. For overloading and for motor starters, we employ thermal relay or under voltage relay. Under voltage relay for overload and motor start, we can employ either thermal relay or under voltage relay. So for radial feeders, we go for definite overcurrent relay. So for transformers and remaining existing feeders except radial feeders, we go for inverse overcurrent relay. For distribution lines and for power transformers, we provide inverse definite minimum time relay. So which is actually characteristics of both inverse current and definite minimum time relays. So next, for non-directional overcurrents, which generally exists for alternator, we employ negative sequence relay alternators. Okay, so now we go for distance relays, and this is also a very 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 important and regularly asked questions. Impedance relay, it is voltage restrained over current reactants today, it is direction restraint over current relay and Moore relay. It is voltage restrained directional relay. So far impedance relay and reactance relay and Moore relay. Impedance relay is used for medium transmission lines and reactance relay is for short transmission lines, and Moore relay is used for long transmission lines. So impedance relay are used for phase faults, reactance relay in short transmission lines are used for depth faults, and Moore relay used for phase faults. Here I would like to provide some more information about impedance relays. Impedance relays, their characteristics will be like, for impedance relays their characteristics will be circle with center as origin. This is stable and unstable. I mean, this is protected zone, this is unprotected zone for impedance relays. For reactance relay, the characteristics is like straight line passing to the parallel to x axis, x and y axis, straight line passing to the straight line parallel to the x axis. And for here it is protected zone and here it is unprotected zone. Okay, Moore relay, for Moore relay this is protected zone and this is unprotected zone. So these are different types of characteristics of impedance relays and reactance relays and Moore relays. Questions will be directly from this point of view. So the characteristics of impedance relay will be straight line parallel to y axis, or circle at center of the origin, circle on the surface of the axis, or any other. So we have to go for circle at the center of the origin for stable operation. If we had asked for unstable operation, we should go for circle outside the origin. Okay, so this is all about relays, and please make sure that you make screenshot or some note, detailed notes about these key points. Thank you for watching, and please do share with your friends and comment your doubts or any kind of this thing with in comment box below. Thank you so much. Thank you.